Adaptive dynamic system in Range Rover is the system that monitors the driving style and road conditions and also makes small adjustments to your suspension for better cornering and overall better steering. The system uses several sensors that are located in the suspension, and if you see the adaptive dynamics fault warning on the dash in 99% of cases, this means that the wiring to those sensors is broken or corroded. In the Range Rover model, the sensors are connected under the bonnet on the top of the struts, and you can easily find and track the cables to see if they are broken or loose. You can even take off the cover on top of the strut to see if the connector is okay. But since it's Land Rover wiring, you will most likely fail to find the issue because it may be a corroded wire inside the isolation and it's very hard to spot. Also, on Range Rover Sport and Evoque, the wiring will be hidden much better and you can only reach it from the wheel well, which makes it pretty hard to inspect and repair something. Anyway, this is an extremely common problem with Range Rover vehicles starting in 2010, and there is a very helpful TSB covering exactly Range Rover models. I will post the number of the TSB in the description and you can check it out to get some tips or at least an understanding of what is failing. I should say that the sensors in the adaptive dynamic system or the suspension parts are almost never the culprits of the problem. It's all about wiring and connectors. And the problem is that now your front suspension moves all the time when you turn and wiring hates to be moved so much. So it will eventually fail. Can you fix it on your own? Well, it's not impossible, but wiring work is not easy, so maybe you will want to find a good independent mechanic and have the job done for like 100-150 euros, since no parts are needed, just about an hour of work. Also, there is a TSB in the US for Jaguar cars that says this adaptive dynamics fault warning may pop up on the dash when the vehicle registers low voltage while cranking. Chances are low that it's your problem, but before you invest in any repairs, you may also want to check if the 12-volt battery is completely healthy.